呈现不一样的演出方式，大家再给他们掌声。
Yeah, so you're not getting rid of me quite yet.
所以你们现在还不能摆脱他。
But I just wanted to take the opportunity to tell a little bit about myself.
他想要用这个机会呢，来跟大家说一下有关他自己的故事。
As you might have noticed when we introduced ourselves, I am from Norway.
所以你们可能有注意到，当他们在自我介绍的时候，他是来自挪威。
I'm so lucky that I get to spend 2 months in Taiwan with this crazy North Americans that I live with.
所以他非常的幸运呢，能够在这两个月可以待在台湾，然后可以跟这群他的队友们一起生活。
But I'll start from the beginning.
但是他会从头开始讲起。
So I was born in Norway 20 years ago.
他二十年前呢，在挪威出生。
And I grew up in the very south.Which is the most religious part of Norway?
但他是出生在比较南边的地方，然后他是一个很虔诚的一个地区。
And so, like many people in that area, I grew up in a Christian home.
所以很多人来自他家乡的很多人都是从基督教家庭长大的。
And for as long as I remember, I've always believed in Jesus Christ.
所以从他有记忆以来，他一直都是相信耶稣的。
So already since I was very young, my parents would bring me to church on Sundays and teach me good values.
所以在他很小的时候，他爸妈就会带他去教会，然后去教他很好的品德。
So before I even really knew what it meant to be a Christian, I called myself a Christian.
所以在他真正了解什么叫做做基督徒之前，他都叫自己是基督徒。
And through the beginning of my childhood, I thought that that was the only option. I thought that everyone believed in Jesus.
所以在他比较早期的童年生活的时候，他觉得这是他唯一的选择。他以为所有的人都相信耶稣。
But after a while, going to Sunday school started becoming really boring to me.
但是过了阵子之后呢，去那个教会做礼拜变得非常，对他来说变得非常的无聊。
And when I figured out that not everyone my age had to go to church, I kind of found that as an excuse and stopped going myself.
所以当他发现说，哦，原来在他这个年纪的学生，并不是所有人都要去教会，所以他就把这个当作成一个借口，然后他决定就是慢慢的不要过去。
And so even though I still believed that Jesus Christ was real, I didn't really let it affect my life in any type of way.
虽然他相信基督教，相信这个宗教，但是他并没有让他去影响他的生活。
And so it wasn't until I was about 12 or 13, my oldest brother introduced me to this new church.
所以在他十二、十三岁的时候，他的哥哥跟他介绍，带他去新的一个教会。
And this church was really good with youth, so it was a place that I could go once a week, have fun with my friends, play games, buy.Candy.
所以就是这个教会，他对青年非常好，所以他可以一个礼拜去那边一次，然后去那边玩啊，然后去那边吃糖果啊之类的。
And so being a Christian was suddenly a lot more fun than I remembered as a kid.
所以因为这个活动呢，所以当基督徒这件事情对他来说就变得更有趣了。
But at that same time that I started going to this youth group, I also got a boyfriend.
所以当他去这个新的教会的时候的同时，他交了一个男朋友。
And basically nothing good came out of that relationship.
所以那一段关系是非常糟糕的。
So this boy was one of my classmates and he was not Christian.
这个男生是他的同学，然后他并不是一位基督徒。
We were dating for about 2 years on and off.And throughout that time, he would always question why I was Christian.
他在两年的时间就一直分分合合，分分合合。然后在这段时间内，他的男朋友都会一直问他说，为什么你是个基督徒？
And he didn't really have any Christian people in his life except me and his grandpa, and he didn't really like his grandpa.
除了他跟他的外公他的阿公以外，那个男生并没有其他的就是基督徒的人。然后，但是他很不喜欢他的阿公。
So towards or throughout those 2 years, even though I went to youth group, I kind of drifted further apart from God.
所以在这分分合合的两年中，虽然他还是去教会，但是他却离神越来越远了。
But it got to a point where most kids' romantic relationships end, and he traded me for another girl.
所以就是很像，我们大家的恋情一样，就是这个结束，就是他去追了另外一个女生。
Typical middle school drama. I thought I was gonna marry him, and I ended up heartbroken.
所以就很像我们看到的那种剧情一样，他以为他自己会嫁给他，可是他却以心碎收尾。
And so when I suddenly lost this big part of my life, I started having to get to know my friends even more, and church became really important to me.
所以因为他经历了这个失去他人生很大部分的这件事情，所以他就慢慢的可以去更认识他的朋友，然后教会这件事也对他来说越来越重要。
And when I say that church got really important to me, I mean that it got really important on Fridays.
所以他说，教会对他越来越重要。他的意思是在礼拜五的时候，教会很重要。
So when I got home from church, I was still kind of like didn't really let Jesus affect my life.
所以当他回到家的时候，其实他也没有真的让耶稣进入他的生活里面。
And so the time went on, and I continued going to this youth group and actually learned a lot.
所以时间就是随着时间过去，他继续去了那一个青年的团队，然后他成长了很多。
I learned more about how God actually loves me and cares for me and wants to have a relationship with me.
然后他就慢慢理解说神其实很爱他，然后很在乎他，然后想要跟他建立一个很好的关系。
And so everything looked pretty great until I started high school.
然后一切都看起来很美好，直到他上了高中。
This was a time in my life where most of my childhood friends and I drifted apart.
然后这个是一个时间，是他跟他的童年的朋友就是都分道扬镳了。
And at the same time, I fought a lot with my parents, and so I didn't really have a good time at school or at home.
所以在这个时间，他也刚好就是跟他爸妈有很多很多的争吵，所以他在学校不开心，回到家也不开心。
So pretty much the only place that I had left where I felt good and had fun was church.
所以只剩下一个地方让他可以觉得他是被爱的，然后是很有趣的，那就是教会。
And so church became really, really important to me again.
所以教会对他来说又变得非常非常重要。
And as the story goes, I got another boyfriend, and I ended up down again.
所以呢，在这个故事继续下去，他又交了一个男朋友，然后他整个人生又到了低潮。
And it got to a point. This was a year ago, where my mom told me that I actually really had to change.
在一年前，他妈妈告诉他说，我真的觉得你应该要改变。
And I still had all of these really great friends from church, and they kept on talking about YWAM and this Bible school in other countries.
然后他仍然有一群很好来自教会的很好的朋友，然后他们就会一直讲有关青年使命团的事情。
And so I knew that was something that I wanted to do myself, and so I found a really cool school where I got to do a lot of fun stuff while still learning so much about Jesus.
所以他就觉得，这是他需要的，然后他很开心，他可以找到一个地方是他可以尽情的玩乐，然后在同时也可以去认识耶稣。
So I got to Australia in January.
所以他在一月的时候到了澳洲。
And my life has completely changed.
然后自此之后，他的生活就大大的改变。
And something that you've probably seen throughout my story is that I've gone a lot of ups and downs.
然后在他故事里面大家可以看到很多的起起落落。
I have gone from loving God to not really caring about his existence.
他从很爱很爱神到变成他不在乎他的存在。
And something that I have learned through all of that and that I can truly see when I look back at my life.
有一件事情是他可以从这件他看过去之后能够学到的事情是
is that even when I did go so much back and forthGod was always there for me.
就算他在生命中经过那么多起起落落，就算他不相信神，相信神，神永远都在那边等着他。
Why? Well, friends left when boyfriends dumped me. God was always there.
当他的朋友离开他，当他的男朋友劈腿的时候，神永远都在那边。
And when I prioritized God and when I pushed him away, he was always there.
当他可能说神的坏话，或者是不让抗拒他，不让他靠近的时候，他还 还是在那边。
I went from thinking that God didn't really care about me to knowing that He loves me and He cares so much about me.
他本来觉得说神其实一点都不在乎，然后他不在乎说他是不是觉得他爱他啊，或者是他在乎他。
And I finally understood that that's how He feels about all of you guys.
然后，但是神其实是很爱我们的，很在乎我们的。那他其实知道说这是想要跟大家讲的，就是神一直都是爱人的。
That was my story. We're gonna end with another song.
So this is his story, and then we're gonna use a song as the
ending. But first, Courtney's gonna say. After she's gonna say something.
After she's gonna say something.
This song is called How He Loves.
This song is called How He Loves. How He Loves.
And it's about Jesus' love for us.
And this is about Jesus' love for us.
Yeah. us tonight, but thank you so much for listening.
这就是我们今天的表演，然后谢谢大家的聆听。
One last thing. We, on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays, we will be at, it's called The Rock Cafe.
所以在每最后一件事情是在每个礼拜二、礼拜四、礼拜五有一个地方叫磐石咖啡馆。
We have free coffee, free tea, and free games if you want to come and hang out with us.
然后我们有免费的咖啡、免费的茶，然后免费的游戏，如果你想要来跟我们聊天的话。
Thank you.